And welcome to our channel MedStudy. Today in this video we are going to see about examination of respiratory system in medicine. So let's get started. First point is general examination. Here we have to look for decubitus, that is lateral decubitus on the side of pleural effusion, abscess, cavity and pleurisy. Tripod position is seen in dyspnea. Patient with severe asthma and COPD sits and leans forwards with shoulders arched forward to assist accessory muscles of respiration. This image shows tripod position. BMI. It is particularly important in cases of obstructive sleep apnea. Raised JVP is seen in cor pulmonale and tension pneumothorax. Pulsus paradoxus is seen in severe asthma and COPD. Respiration, we have to look for rhythm, type and use of accessory muscles of respiration. Edema is seen in cor pulmonale. Clubbing is seen in empyema, bronchiectasis, lung abscess, lung cancer and interstitial lung disease. Skin, we have to look for tobacco staining, subcutaneous nodule in rheumatoid arthritis. Here it shows tobacco staining. Now others include asterixis, that is flapping tremors, as seen in hypercapnic encephalopathy. And spine, to look for kyphoscoliosis, we have to look for TB stigmata, and we have to look for pursed lips as seen in COPD. Here the image shows asterixis and this image shows pursed lips as seen in COPD. Now coming to inspection. First is upper respiratory tract. It includes oral cavity. We have to look for hygiene, dental caries and tonsils. In nose, we have to look for deviated nasal septum, nasal polyps and post nasal drip. We have to look for position of trachea. Trail sign: prominence of clavicular head of sternocleidomastoid to the side to which trachea is deviated. Regions to be inspected are supraclavicular, infraclavicular, mammary, axillary, suprascapular, infrascapular and interscapular. We have to look for drooping of shoulders, scars, sinuses and dilated veins. You have to look for movement of chest. Normal movement is bilaterally symmetrical and elliptical. Unilateral decrease in chest movements is seen in fibrosis, consolidation, collapse, pleural effusion and pneumothorax. Bilateral decrease in chest movement is seen in COPD and ILDs. You have to look for deformities of chest and spine. First is pectus carinatum, that is pigeon chest, pectus excavatum, that is funnel chest, barrel chest. We have to look for Harrison's sulcus, that is undraping of lower ribs just above the costal margins along the line of attachment of diaphragm as seen in rickets, childhood asthma. This shows Harrison's sulcus. Then we have to look for spine for kyphosis and scoliosis. Now coming to palpation. First is palpation of trachea. Keep your index finger and ring finger on the sternal head of sternocleidomastoid. Palpate for the tracheal rings with your middle finger. Compare the empty spaces on both sides of the trachea. Slight displacement to right side is normal. Tracheal deviation to the side of pathology is seen in atelectasis, collapse and lung fibrosis, while tracheal deviation away from the side of pathology is seen in pleural effusion, large mediastinal masses, neck or thyroid mass and pneumothorax. In pulmonary consolidation, there is no tracheal deviation. Now chest expansion. You have to measure it with a measuring tape. Measure the chest circumference after deep inspiration and expiration. You have to measure it at the level of nipples. Normal chest expansion is 5 to 8 cm. It is decreased in COPD and emphysema. You have to palpate for symmetry of chest expansion. Make the patient sit or stand with hands by his side. To measure anterior thoracic movement, stand in front of the patient, place your hands firmly on the chest wall and look for anterior posterior movement with the palms. Extend your fingers around the side of patient's chest with thumbs approximating in the midline without touching. Ask patient to take deep breaths and look for the movement of your thumb from the midline. To measure posterior thoracic movement, you have to face the back of patient. Keep your fingers of both hands on the lower part of ribcage with thumbs approximating in the midline. Hold a loose fold of skin between your thumbs. On deep inspiration, normally the skin fold between the thumb disappears. Now continuing with symmetry of chest expansion, unilateral decrease in chest expansion is seen in pleural effusion, lung or lobar collapse, pneumothorax and unilateral fibrosis. Bilateral decrease in chest expansion is seen in severe COPD, diffuse pulmonary fibrosis. We have to palpate for tactile vocal parameters. Palpation of the chest wall for vibrations transmitted from larynx through the lungs onto the chest wall. Use ulnar border of hand for palpation. Keep the ulnar border of your hand on the chest and ask the patient words like 9, 9 or 1, 1. Increased tactile vocal parameters is seen in consolidation as in pneumonia, while decreased tactile vocal parameters is seen in COPD, asthma and pleural effusion. Now coming to percussion. Striking over the air-filled structures gives resonant note, while striking over fluid-filled structures gives dull note. Tenderness during percussion is seen in emphysema and parietal pleural effusion. Percussion, continuing with percussion, anterior chest wall percussion is done with patients sitting with arms by the side. Apex of the lungs is percussed by standing behind the patient. Lateral chest wall, patient sitting with hands over the head. For posterior chest wall, patient is sitting with hands over the opposite shoulder and head bent forwards. Tidal percussion. Percuss along the right mediclavicular line from second intercostal space going downwards. Normally, the upper border of liver dullness is found in fifth intercostal space. In case of hyperinflated lungs, the resonant note is present even below the sixth intercostal space, as seen in emphysema and asthma. Ask patient to take deep inspiration and percuss again. If dullness disappears, it is due to liver. If dullness persists, it is due to pleural effusion or consolidation. Trove space. Normally, it is a hyper-resonant note due to gastric air bubble. Obliteration of this place is seen in full stomach, left pleural effusion and pericardial effusion. Coming to auscultation. Succession splash. In hydropneumothorax, at first, percuss to find the upper border of dullness. Now keep the stethoscope at the junction of dullness and resonance. Hold the patient's shoulder and shake vigorously. Splashing sound can be heard through the stethoscope. Normal grid sounds are low-pitched and rustling in nature, as these are vesicular. Louder and prolonged during inspiration, there is no pause between inspiration and expiration. Breath sounds are decreased in emphysema, asthma, pleural effusion, pleural thickening and tumor. While breath sounds are absent in massive pleural effusion, thickened pleura, pneumothorax and collapsed lung. Bronchial breath sounds. These are high-pitched breath sounds similar to those heard over the trachea and larynx. Inspiratory and expiratory are of same duration and intensity with a pause in between. Tubular, pneumonic consolidation, collapsed lungs with patent bronchi above the level of pleural effusion. Cavernous type seen in tuberculous cavitation. And amphoric type are seen in bronchopleural fistula, tension pneumothorax. Bronchovesicular breath sounds. These are intermediate of character between bronchial and vesicular. Expiratory sound is louder, longer, and high pitched than the inspiratory sound. Added sounds. These are crackles, which are explosive, interrupted, non-musical sounds resulting from collapse of peripheral airways on expiration. These are seen in pulmonary edema, bronchiectasis, and interstitial lung disease. Stridor is a loud, high-pitched sound heard during inspiration. Ronchi are continued low-pitched muscle sounds caused due to obstruction or secretion in the large airways, as seen in bronchiectasis, pneumonia, and cystic fibrosis. Pleural rub is a crackling or grating sound caused due to friction resistance between two layers of the inflamed pleura. Wheeze, it is a continuous sound caused by flow of air through the narrowed airways. Vocal resonance, bronchophony, it is voice sounds heard unduly loud, seen with consolidation due to pneumonia. Egophony, in which auscultated voice sounds have a peculiar nasal quality, as seen in consolidation and fibrosis. So this completes with the respiratory system examination. I hope you liked the video. Please do like, share and subscribe to our channel MedStudy. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will never miss an update. Thank you.